Hey, welcome to RGB LED, How to Program Color. Today we're going to investigate what the RGB color model is, talk about how it's used, and then you're going to get a chance to actually program your code node to give you different variations of color. For this activity today, all you're going to need is your student sheet out of the workbook or whatever one your teacher has given you, your code node, and then of course your SparkView software with Blockly. All right, so what is an RGB color model? Well, essentially it's an additive color model that uses red, green, and blue lights. When you mix these together, you get various different colors. What's really neat about RGB LED is that we use it in digital devices. You see it on TV monitors, on your computer monitors, and even in digital camera views. So RGB is used everywhere. You can adjust the color of red, green, and blue from 0 to 255. So essentially that means you can make 256 different shades of red, green, and blue. Well, when you mix those shades together, take a guess at how many colors you can make. Over 16 million. So let's take a step back first and think about elementary school. When you were in elementary school, you learned about primary colors and how you could mix them to get secondary colors. So what do you get when you mix yellow and blue? If you said green, you're right. But we have to remember here, when we're talking about that in art class, those color mixings are what we call pigments. So it's color of pigments. The RGB LED is the color of light. Okay, so we talked about RGB LED in monitors. Your RGB LED on your code node, right over here, has a red, green, and blue light. You can mix the brightness of each of these from 0 to 10. And when you adjust that brightness, you can actually get different colors. So let's get started. For this activity, you are going to first use Blockly to create a quick program that initiates the RGB LED light to come on. You're going to set 10 as the intensity for red, green, and blue and see what color you get. Then you're going to play a little bit with adjusting the intensity of those colors. And then you're going to face a challenge. You're going to replicate the RGB color model and you are going to create cyan, magenta, and yellow. All right, so what I'm going to ask you to do right now is to pause the video, refer to the student activity sheet for the directions, and do those three main things. See what color you get when you set intensity to 10 on red, green, blue. Adjust that intensity, see what happens to the light, and then create cyan, magenta, and yellow. All right, welcome back. Hopefully you were successful. I'm sure you were. You are now a color modeling expert with the RGB color model. But in case you had a little bit of a challenge and you want to see how I did it, I'm going to do it with you. All right, so the first thing I did is I connected my code node to SparkView, and I'm going to choose just the graph display. It really doesn't matter for this piece. And I want to have a graph that shows brightness over time, but we're not even really going to use that here. You're going to go directly to the code icon that brings you into Blockly. So we need to create a quick program that'll initiate the RGB LED light to come on so you can adjust the brightness of the red, green, and blue LEDs. I'm going to make a simple loop that's repeat while true. Make that bigger so you can see. And that's just essentially telling the computer to run through the program nonstop over and over and over. I'm going to bring in my conditional statement and a comparison block. And I'm going to say if the value of the brightness, let's see. I'm going to go back here so I can look at my real-time data bar. I'm in a pretty bright room because we're here in the production room, and it's saying it's about 7.81% right now. So that's important in my program because I'm going to say if the value of the brightness goes below, let's say 3%, it's then going to trigger my RGB LED light to come on. And you find that all the way at the bottom in hardware. Now remember, the directions said to start by setting each of these intensities to 10. Set that up. Now I also have to add an else statement. You can bring another block over or right click to duplicate. And if the brightness isn't less than 3%, I want these lights to be off. All right, this looks good. So I'm gonna go ahead and click start, and we're gonna look, and if I program this correctly, when I cover the light sensor, the eye here, my RGB LED light should come on. All right, let's see. There we go. And that's pretty bright. So now you see what color you get when you mix yellow, green, and blue light. I'm gonna stop collecting data and adjust the intensity of these down to 5. What do you think's gonna happen? Is the color gonna change? Let's find out. I'm gonna click start. Cover the light sensor. Do you notice the difference? It might be a little hard here in the studio, but when you do it yourself, you'll see that it's not as bright. It's not as intense. All right, I'm not gonna run through every single one of the colors, but let's do one together to see if you were able to do it. I wanna create magenta. So the two colors that I'm going to want are red and blue. So I'm just gonna zero out the green. And I'm gonna put these to 10 so you can get a good view here in the studio. And click start. And there we go. You have magenta. All right, so hopefully you were successful. The RGB color model is important to you. Programmers need to know about this. You can do all sorts of fun things with other sensors here. And remember, you see them every day in your TV screens, your monitors, and your digital camera displays. Thanks for joining.